it's so lovely to have you here with me on tonight's show, especially as we have a wonderful guest for you. Singer Maggie Reilly joins us, and here is what happened when I caught up with her. Maggie, it's great to have you on the show. How are you?
Thanks, it's great to be here, Hayley. I'm fine, really good, I think.
Oh, wonderful. And you're up in Scotland at the moment, is that right?
Yep, yep.
Yes. Oh, wonderful.
In the rain.
In the rain. Oh, no. It's always the way, isn't it? Yeah. And obviously, we've sort of come out of lockdown now. How's life been treating you?
Not too bad. We were able to go to Ireland last week, which was nice.
Yes.
And actually, yeah, you can go out and about quite a lot, really. Yeah. Same as everywhere.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's nice to be back, isn't it? Well, we're going to go into the first song of the show this evening, Moonlight Shadow. Did you ever think it would be such a big hit for you and Mike Oldfield?
I think we thought it was a lovely song, but it's had a much longer life than I think any of us thought it would have. Yeah. I mean, people just love the song. They just love it.
They really do. And it's an absolute timeless classic,
it is,
isn't it?
And years and years. Yeah. I was very young when I did it.
No, and it's a great looking video as well. Tell us, what can you remember from that filming?
Being very hot. It was a really hot day and they had a fire in the shoot. We had to stand in front of it. And I just remember every so often when they stopped, I would be like, just got to get a breath now. Because we were placed right in front of the fireplace. And it was in a really lovely big house outside of London. And we just had a lot of fun. It was good fun.
Yeah. And one of our viewers, Janet, says it's a really important chapter of your career with Mike. What are your best memories of working with him?
Best memories, we did a lot of touring, which was fantastic. The guys in the band were amazing. And we just did a lot of fun going to some really interesting places. The concerts were brilliant, particularly one in Greece that was in an amphitheatre, and it was just like magical. People were hanging off the rocks in front of the stage and things. It was stunning. And we did this song Diana, and as I started to sing it, the moon just came right above me.
Wow.
And it was like, whoa.
God.
Whoa. And then I mean,
one of those
lots
moments.
Of great memories, really. We did tours of interesting places in Europe at one point. And that included meeting some people who'd run away to join a French army, and it was all, you know, the legionnaires, they'd gone off and they sort of came to the show. It was like, wow, amazing. The foreign legion.
Oh, what wonderful memories.
And also very hard work. Lots of very hard work.
Of course, that people don't see that goes on behind the scenes, right?
But also the recording part was always really hard, because Mike had a vision and we would spend a lot of time in the studio, which would be quite tough sometimes. You'd get very tired and then you'd come upon the thing that you wanted and it was like, yay! You know, it was all worth it. But I think Moonlight Shadow didn't take very long. It was one of the easier things to do.
All right.
So simplicity is the thing, I think, maybe.
Yes, it works, doesn't it? It really does. We're going to play it out on the show now, Maggie. Here is Moonlight Shadow, number 4 in 1983. Enjoy. Now, Maggie, just rewinding back, I know that your father was a singer. Was that your love for how your music was born?
Maybe, I don't know. It's just something that was always around, and my mum played piano. And there was always music in the house.
Yeah. And did you know it was that music that you always wanted to do? Was that your vision?
Yeah, I think so. I had no ambition to do anything else, really, other than work on the tram cars in Glasgow, because they had these funny little machines that spat out the tickets. And I used to think, I'd really like one of those machines. other than that, no, I just, singing was what
it was. The singing that was your vision. Yeah, just wonderful. And I mean, your professional career began in 1970 when you recorded Imagine Me, and then you formed the band Joe Cool, which morphed into the band Caderbell. Talk us through that time, Maggie.
Well, it was a friend of mine, actually, who wrote a song. He wrote a few songs. And he asked me to sing a couple of them to send to London because he was looking for a publishing deal. And they got in touch and said they wanted me to go and record, which I went and did. That was where Imagine Me came from. And then I realised that they were wanting me to do stuff that I didn't really want to do. And so I came back to Scotland. And that was where Joe Cool was formed then. Just got to meet with people and sort of decided I was going to do that. And then we played around for a while in Scotland. And then we got together with some other guys from another band called Up. And we formed Cado Bell.
Right.
And then we just toured, wrote, toured.
Yeah.
And just had a fantastic time, really.
Wow. Oh, wonderful times. And, I mean, your career has been spanning over four decades. Did you ever think you'd have so much success?
It's been a kind of weird thing because I've turned an awful lot of things down, mostly because there were people who I really admired and I kind of was anxious I wasn't going to be good enough to work with them because I thought they were so fantastic. And other things have just come along and happened just, you know, without me pursuing them, and it's been great, actually. But I think I could have been much richer and maybe done a lot more work if I'd applied myself a bit more.
Oh, but things happen and you deal with them at the time, don't you? And you know, you've had an incredible career.
Yeah, and I mean, I was the singer in Billy Connolly's first big theatre show. For some reason I named myself Elaine Charles. I'm not really sure where that came from, but it was, you had to have a stage name or something. So I saw Billy when he was like just on the beginning of going to be absolutely huge, and he was the most amazing person to work with because every night people would heckle him and he was just so fast, you know, he would just come back with something and you'd go, yes, done it, you know. So I've had quite a varied career.
You really have. It's just incredible, Maggie. Well, we're going to go into the next song, which is actually a video of you and Cado Bell performing Infamous Mister. So we're going to play that and we'll be talking to Maggie Reilly on the other side of this. Now, Maggie, I know that you've chosen this week's Saturday Night Song of the Week. Tell us why you've chosen this.
Well, I used to work with a guitarist called Andy Roberts, very famous, brilliant folk guitarist. And this is by his two kids. And he posted it and I saw it and I just couldn't stop thinking about it. It's the most fantastic song. And so when I was asked, would I like to put something out there, and I got in touch, and Will was absolutely thrilled because he arranged and produced everything and so and played a lot of the stuff, so he was really thrilled. But Millie, who sings it, his sister, she was a little bit worried about not giving Pip the promotion for having written the song. So she said to me, I have no problem with you playing it as long as you let everyone know that Pip wrote the song. And so it's very much up there on the front of the video. But I just think Millie and Will, they've just made a fantastic version of it, and so I'd love people to hear it.
Yes. Well, we're going to be playing that later on in the show, a wonderful song. And talking of another wonderful song, we're going to be playing out Follow the Midnight Sun. This is such a beautiful song. What's the story behind this?
I wrote most of it in an empty flat that my mum was about to move into in London. And it was a track that was sent to me by a German producer I was working with, and I just thought it was a lovely image, you know, nice imagery of the people, and we made a brilliant video of it in Spain.
Yeah.
And my little boy is there holding the banner when he was a tiny tot. Aww. So it's something I really love. Every so often when I see it, it's great because, well, how often do you get to see your kid in a really nice video?
Oh, we're going to take a little trip down memory lane and check that out now, and we'll see you after. Now, Maggie, I know you're a really busy performer, especially popular in Germany and Scandinavia. What is it that you think makes you so popular over there?
I don't know. I've just worked there a lot over the years, and I suppose they're just yeah. used to me being there and sort of turning up and going, I'll play there. That looks like an interesting venue. I'll come. No, it's great because I've managed to see places that I would never have seen normally.
Yeah.
Just no chance to go to some of the really interesting, like we played an island off the coast of Hamburg.
Lovely.
A few years back, and it was, you got the boat, you got over there, people came on a boat to the show, they had a meal at the one hotel there, and then they left, and it was like you had this little island to yourself. You could actually see from where you stood, you could see the end of the island, you know. It was very small, fantastic.
Yeah, yeah, really good opportunities. And yeah, how brilliant is it to be back on stage again? Because obviously we've all been through a rough time. I bet just being on that stage and having the crowd singing back to you, is that a real special moment for you?
It will be. At the moment, I've been asked to do some shows in Finland and Estonia, but the practicalities of it in the next couple of months are impossible because band-wise, getting everybody... whatever paperwork we need to get there and all the stuff. But I'm hoping to do some things around about Christmas because I've got a Christmas album coming out.
Oh, great.
And I am desperate to actually play it, you know, because I just love it. I've wanted to do one for years and I decided, right, I'm going to do
it. Now's the time, yeah.
So I did, and it was snowy. We did it up a mountain outside Glasgow, up in the hillsides.
Oh, wow.
And we got a little studio there. And we recorded, and some days we couldn't get to the studio because the ice and snow had come too far down the hill. So it was great fun though.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping to get out soon, but I'm definitely going to be out touring beginning of next year.
Okay, well, we're going to put details of on your screens now of your website so people can check out your album and moving forward with your gigs. Now, we've got a video of you performing in Germany. Here is A Stone's Throw from Nowhere. Enjoy.
Standing sideways to the sky.
We've got some questions from some of our lovely viewers, Maggie. Anne would like to know, you've worked with some great names, including Cliff Richards, Sisters of Mercy, Smokey, Nick Mason and Jack Bruce, to name but a few. Who's been your favourite to collab with?
Collaborator? Probably Jack Bruce, because I was a massive, massive, massive Jack Bruce solo album fan. And so I met him in a hotel when we were on tour. And we got chatting. And then years later, I got a call asking if I would record with him. And because I'd met him and I'd kind of been chatting with him, it was okay because I'd already met him, you know. And so it was like, went out to do the album thing with him. And it was just lovely. It was fantastic. And a few years ago, his son Malcolm put together a benefit in London. And everybody that had ever worked with Jack came and played and stuff, and it was really great. It was lovely. It's just a shame he's not here anymore.
Yeah,
fantastic.
Oh, what wonderful
musician.
Memories though.
Yeah
he really was. And is there anyone that you'd like to collab with moving forward?
Moving forward, I wish I'd said yes to John Martin and Jerry Rafferty. It's too late. I don't know. I like surprises. And like with the Sisters of Mercy, when I got a call and asked would I be interested in doing that, it was so out of anything that anybody imagined I would do that I thought, I'd really like that. That'd be interesting. So I'm kind of open to all sorts of things.
Who knows?
So I'm and, open.
Anyone watching, watch this space. And Tim, one of our viewers, says, what inspires you to write most of your songs?
Well, I work mainly with Stuart McKillop. I do work with other people, but mostly I've always worked with Stuart. And it's usually he'll bring me a melody and I'll sort of think something will come into my head that it sounds like it should be this. And then I write a lyric from that. Sometimes I just come up with stuff myself, or I'll come up with a tune or something and then we work on it. But it's generally like picking it out of the air, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
God, Love that. Well, we're going to go into Family Man, which I know that you co-wrote the lyrics on this song. What was the inspiration behind this, Maggie?
It kind of says it all in the song, really. We'd done a lot of touring over a very long period of time, and it had been the same band, same group of people, more or less. And it was just the guys came up with this idea, and we just all sat down and wrote different parts of it.
Yeah. Oh, wonderful. We're going to play it out on the show now, UK 45 in 1982. Enjoy.
She wore such a smile, she took a standard pose, she presented herself.
Now we're going to finish on the last song, Heaven Sent, which I know we've got a live clip of you singing that. But Maggie, it's been such a pleasure to have you here on the show this evening. Take a real trip down memory lane. And we both learned that we are technical goddesses, aren't we?
Yes.
We've learned a lot about Zoom.
Technology is my thing. Absolutely.
Oh, well, thank you so much. And we want to remind everyone to check out your Christmas album as well. So we're going to put details on the screen below. But Maggie, thank you so much. It's been a real pleasure.
Thank you, Hayley. It's been really nice. Once the technical stuff was out of the way, great.
Thank you. It's Maggie Reilly, everyone.
Bye.
Oh, huge thank you, Maggie Reilly, for being such a wonderful guest on tonight's show. And thank you to you at home for supporting the show. It really is very much appreciated. Thank you. Now, I will see you same time, same place next week. We're going to leave you with a Pip Millett song, Ava, by Millie and Will Roberts, as this week's Saturday Night Song of the Week.
Hi, I'm Will Roberts. I produced and arranged this track, Ava, in lockdown last year in my bedroom with my sister, Millie. Pip Millett is a great songwriter, and we both really wanted to do a cover of one of her songs, and I just hope that we did it justice.
Crying. times when you were there for me and you cared for me, my love, my love, my love, my love, my Ava. Don't be scared, my Ava. Don't be scared, my love, my love, my love, my love, my love, my.